Hello, this is Hiroshi Yamazoe. In this video, I will talk about my past traumatic experience in detail. As I have said in other videos, I was bullied around the age of 10 and became very afraid of people. This led me to stop going to school, which led me to a very difficult relationship with my parents, and my parents began to neglect me, causing me to become a severe hikikomori state for a long period of time. So in this video, I would like to talk about the details of that my traumatic experience of being bullied in my child age. Currently, I live in theLarge city called Nagoya in Aichi Prefecture. But when I was a child, I lived in a small city in the countryside of Shiga Prefecture, a city that probably looks to people foreigner like medieval Japan, the kind of place you would see in a film about samurais.And when I was a child, I was a very shy person. I'm still very shy person now too. But back then, I was even more shy and could hardly have a conversation with people. But I had few friends, even though they were very few. I got along with those friends and played TV games or played inthe forest together. And at that time, my grades in school were not bad, and I just diligently did my studies and homework from school. I never opposed the teachers. I was just a kid who obeyed the adults quietly. I never got into anyfight with anyone too. I was just a quiet and inconspicuous person. In my town, there was an event where elementary school children would gather together to play a traditional Japanese card game called Hyakunin Ishu. Only children of the same age in the neighborhood would gather in the Japanese style room of each house to play this card game, Hyakunin Ishu. There were no adults around. It's an event for children only. And the bullying began at this event. Six children, including myself,started playing that card game called Hyakunin Ishu. Those were children around 10 years old, and two of them were, I thought, were supposed to be my good friends. Then suddenly the bullying started. One of them started talking abusively to me. He started calling me an idiot or something andslandering me. He used many bad words and cursed me. I had no idea why he was saying such things to me, but I didn't say anything back. I just felt very uncomfortable. He seemed to be very angry and very resentfultowards me, but I had no idea where his anger was coming from, so I 100% didn't understand of what was going on. He was a son of one of the richest and powerful family in my town, and the other kids around me looked up to him. and the bullying gradually escalated and the powerful kid who was leading the bullying began to use other kids to beat me up. And this physical violence also gradually escalated and eventually I was beaten and kicked so badly that I was bleeding internally and covered with bruises. And the shocking thing was that the two people who I thought were my few important friends were looking at me like it was so amusing as I was being kicked and punched. They began to mock me, making fun of me, imitating the way I was being beaten and hurt. I didn't fight against them because I didn't know how to win against them by only myself. They are many, and if I fight, I will be revenged by multiple times, and I knew that talking to my parents or school would not solve the problem. This is because parents and teachers have a local community, and the parents of the bullies, who are the majority in that community, will take the side of the bullies. So fighting is just suicide act. This means that a single child of about 10 years old will have to fight so many people, including adults, and that's impossible. So just I endure it, hoping that the torture would stop someday. But it didn't stop at all, even after many months. For several months, they persisted in beating me up. And one time, one of them grabbed me by the skin of my face with both hands and pulled so hard that I started crying from the extreme pain. Then, when they saw me crying, they mocking it and make fun of me. Afterwards, my cheek was bleeding internally and was red and swollen so hard. But no one cared, and even after that, the violence did not finish. And at some point, the guy who was leading the bullying on me started carrying around a survival knife. It has a huge blade. He began to glimpse that large knife at me sometimes. Apparently, it is a purposeful manner. I think he became paranoid that I would tell my parents or teachers, or I would revenge to him. So I think he was threatening me by showing me that knife. I thought he was going to kill me someday because he was paranoid. Then one day there was an incident at school. And at the time, students at the school were raising rabbits in a shed. It is a part of learning program to teach students about animals and life through the process of raising rabbits. And one day, the rabbits were slaughtered by some sharp blade. It was a big news and trouble for the school. I was not sure, but I thought that perhaps he had killed the rabbits with that large knife. I thought that one day he would kill me too. And one day, a festival was held in my town. It was a traditional festival called Dondo Yaki, which is held in many parts of Japan, especially in the rural areas. It is a festival where people make bundles of bamboos and woods and burn them and roast rice cakes and other food over the fire. A lot of people, from adults to children, participate in this festival, and I and the bullies also participated in this festival. I was sitting in a corner at the festival, and they came, and one of them said to me, "Get out of here." The person who said this was a friend that I used to be very close to, and the adults around me didn't say anything, so I just walked out of the festival, as he said. I just spent the rest of the day of the festival alone in some dark forest. This is a symbolic experience that remains in my memory. At the time, I thought that wherever I would go, I would be attacked or excluded, and I thought there is no place for me in this world. But I felt a certain sense of relief because I began to no desire to be in such a cruel world anymore. I began to think that everything about this world is unimportant. If the world doesn't care about me, then I don't have to care about the world as well. I no longer had any reason to care about the world or society. So I felt a kind of relief from that. And the bullying didn't end after that either. It seemed as if it would never end until I am dead. No matter how much I cried or begged, they would never forgive me. What had I done to them? I had no idea where their hatred for me was coming from. And it wasn't just hatred for me that they had inside them. It was pleasure. They seemed to take great pleasure in torturing me. This was their entertainment. My suffering was their pleasure. This situation drove me insane. They beat me, kicked me, and made fun of me a daily basis for their enjoyment. And I began to have suicidal thoughts. And when I was around 11 years old, I bought a rope and tried to kill myself, but I was too scared to die. Fortunately, when I went to junior high school, the bullies stopped coming around me and the problem went away. However, in the second year of junior high school, one of the bullies placed in the same class with me, and this bully acted like he was a good friend to me. I felt very sick about it. I felt so bad that I stopped going to school anymore and became a hikikomori. That's how I finally solved my relationship with the police. It was solved when I dropped out and became a hikikomori. However, their existence continued to torment me further even when I became a hikikomori. This is because they were accepted by their teachers as superior students, went on to higher education, graduated from college, got good jobs such as bankers and civil servants, and got married, had children, and went on with their lives as successful people. I found that by researching them on the internet, they are seemed like living their lives as good members of the society without any remorse. That fact made me even more insane. Those who were bullied were neglected in society, while those who were bullying were accepted in society, made good friends, supported by society, receiving social resources fully, grew up, fell in love, had children and families, and gained rich lives. This is a very painful reality. This phenomenon is linked to my mistrust of the society. I became a long-term severe hikikomori, and many things happened to me during my hikikomori years too. In particular, the worsening relationship with my parents was a big problem. I would like to talk about the details of my hikikomori years in another video someday. So this time I talked about my traumatic experience of being bullied. It was a dark story, but I have said in other videos, I am not in a despair at all. I have hope about the future. I will overcome this trauma and achieve something great that will even surpass those who were tortured me in my child age. I will continue to do various things for it, and I will continue to post the videos on this channel. I have a lot of things planned for this channel. If you are interested, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.